my privilege to introduce our keynote speaker, Jeff Foster, the Senior Policy Advisor for Capital Markets at the U.S. Department of Treasury. Jeff has worked on a wide range of topics related to financial stability and financial reform, including most recently the development of the administration's report to Congress on housing finance reform. And we're looking forward to his insights on this white paper and the Q&A that will follow his presentation.
Housing reform is a critically important topic, as this large turnout indicates and as this series will illustrate. As you all know, about a month ago, the administration released our plan for reforming America's housing finance market. The range of perspectives that we've heard has really been the basis for the formation of our paper. While we've laid the groundwork for some important first steps with the release of the paper, our work is clearly not finished. It really is just beginning, and as we go forward, we look forward to continuing these conversations, engaging in these events, and work together to implement the reforms that were laid out as we work with Congress through the legislative process. Our plan recognizes that the essential components of housing finance are fundamentally private sector activities. The private sector should be the one that bears the mortgage risk and is the primary source of capital. It also recognizes the critical importance that the securitization markets play in credit formation and emphasizes that while there's been very little new issuance in the private label securities market in the last 2 years, it is imperative that we reform the flaws in the previous system so that private markets can once again provide capital for homeowners to take out a mortgage. Our plan focuses on several transition steps and presents three potential options for the long-term structure of the housing finance system. Together, these actions will help gradually wind down Fannie and Freddie and to start to shrink the government's footprint in housing finance. We must restore confidence in the housing market and the housing finance system so that borrowers, lenders, and investors have the confidence to buy a house, make a loan, or provide the capital to the industry necessary by fixing the substantial flaws in the mortgage market. There are a number of avenues which we will address these issues, and there are a number of initiatives already underway, including the important work that FHA and FHFA is doing in the review of servicer compensation. That is an important reform to get right, and we recognize the important dialogue with SIFMA on this effort. The presence of a well-functioning TBA market in a fully reformed system will depend on the long-term path of reform and should be an important consideration in the debate over the future of housing finance in the coming months. And that ultimately, part of putting private capital back at the core function, at the center of our housing finance system, is allowing private capital to be innovative, to be flexible, and to continue to provide benefits within the right construct of safety and soundness and appropriate prudential regulation.